quasi-geostrophic omega equation is what we're going to be working with now over here. And again, we're going to be looking at the quasi-geostrophic vorticity equation and the thermodynamic energy equation in order to talk about the quasi-geostrophic omega equation. And we're going to start out again with the vorticity equation over here. Partial zeta g partial t is equal to minus ug dot del of zeta g plus f naught partial omega partial p. And then we're going to again be looking at the relationship between the vertical vorticity and the geopotential field over here to get the following. Again, plugging in these relationships into this equation over here. 1 over f naught del squared of partial phi partial t is equal to minus ug dot del of 1 over f naught del squared phi plus f naught partial omega partial p. All right, so that's starting out with the vorticity equation from the left-hand side over here. And then we're going to also use the quasi-geostrophic thermodynamic energy equation over here to get the following. Partial t of minus partial phi partial p is equal to minus ug dot del minus partial phi partial p plus sigma omega. And we're going to just switch the order of differentiation on the left-hand side of this equation and multiply out the minus signs on the first term on the right-hand side of the equation to get the following. Minus partial p of partial phi partial t is equal to ug dot del of partial phi partial p plus sigma omega. All right, so again, this is dealing with over here the vorticity equation and over here the thermodynamic energy equation over there. All right, now we're going to start combining these equations accordingly, and I'll just write out the steps over here. First, we're going to be taking f naught of partial p of the vorticity equation over here. So just write this out over here so you can see in your notes exactly what steps we took. So we're taking f naught partial p of both sides of the vorticity equation to get the following. F naught times partial p of 1 over f naught del squared partial phi partial t is equal to f naught partial p of minus ug dot del of 1 over f naught del squared phi plus f naught partial p of f naught partial omega partial p. And then we're going to deal with the thermodynamic energy equation. We're going to take del squared of the thermodynamic energy equation to get the following. Del squared of minus partial p of partial phi partial t is equal to del squared of ug dot del of partial phi partial p plus sigma omega over here. All right, so now we have performed optimal, use that phrase, manipulations of both the vorticity equation and the thermodynamic energy equation in order to eventually get something that is the quasi-geostrophic omega equation. So what we're going to do is we're going to switch the order of the derivatives on the left-hand sides of these equations over here. And that will be one step over here, and also do some rewriting specifically for the thermodynamic energy equation. So we're going to deal with this system of equations over here, and let me see, I'm going to write them down here. Is that going to pose any problems? All right. Starting out with the vorticity equation, partial p of del squared partial phi partial t, I'll even write vort over here, so you see what we're talking about, is equal to f naught partial p of minus ug dot del of 1 over f naught del squared phi plus f naught squared partial squared omega partial p squared. So just effectively dividing out these f naughts over here, and that leaves us with the left-hand side and then rewriting the right-hand side. And then those manipulations I talked about for the thermodynamic energy equation leaves us with the following. Minus partial p of, flipping the order of derivatives, del squared, so of del squared, partial phi partial t is equal to del squared of ug dot del partial phi partial p plus sigma del squared omega. So that over here is just effectively the del squared operator acting on these terms over here. And now we have our system of equations that looks like this. All right, now what we're going to do, similar to last time, is we're going to add these together. Well, that's nice. What happens on the left-hand side? Effectively, our chi over here, remember last time we wanted to eliminate omega. Now, the way we had these manipulations work out is the chi goes away when we add these equations together, with these being exact same magnitude terms off just by a sign. And we get zero on the left-hand side of the equation. Zero is equal to F naught partial P, so we're adding these together, of minus UG dot del 1 over F naught del squared phi plus F. Plus F naught squared partial squared omega partial p squared plus del squared of ug dot del partial phi partial p plus sigma del squared omega. All right, so we have zero, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4 terms on the right-hand side. We've just added these equations together. And we're going to do is we're going to take this term over here and bring that over to the left-hand side, along with this term over here. And you're going to see what's happening. We're going to be effectively constructing a three-dimensional Laplacian, once again, that's going to be acting on omega to give us the following: minus F naught squared partial squared omega partial p squared minus sigma del squared omega is equal to F naught partial p of minus ug dot del of 1 over F naught del squared phi plus F plus del squared of ug dot del of partial phi partial p. All right? And what we're going to do now is just multiply both sides by minus 1 to give us the following on the left-hand side: F naught squared partial squared omega partial p squared plus sigma del squared omega is equal to the following: F naught partial p of, well, when we multiply by the minus 1 of both for both sides, that effectively goes to a positive sign over here. So F naught partial P, I'll just put a plus sign just to see, just to show what happens with that. UG dot del of 1 over F naught del squared phi plus F minus del squared UG dot del partial phi partial P. All right, now what we're going to do is we can effectively at this point come up with our left-hand side three-dimensional Laplacian operator acting on omega. We're going to pull out a sigma over here. And when we do that, yes, we pull it away from here, but then we're going to have to divide by a sigma on this term over here so that we get 1 in terms of the coefficient related to sigma adjacent to partial squared omega partial p squared. So sigma times del squared, that's this over here, plus F naught squared over sigma, so the sigmas divide out, because there's no sigma downstairs over there, partial squared, partial p squared times omega is equal to, and remember we want minus partial p, because they're like partial z, so we're going to have a minus F naught partial p of minus ug dot del of 1 over F naught del squared phi plus F minus, and then we're going to maintain the minus sign over here, del squared of minus and minus over here, so we're dealing with minus partial p's, minus ug dot del of minus partial phi partial p. And this is the quasi-geostrophic omega equation. And remember, omega, we're talking about vertical velocity with pressure as the vertical coordinate, not height. All right, let's talk about physically what's going on the right-hand side. All right, absolute vorticity, advection of absolute vorticity, rate of change of this term over here, vorticity advection, with, as we go up in the atmosphere, minus partial p. So if we have vorticity advection, differential vorticity advection, dVA. And then over here, we have minus del squared. Well, we talked about how second derivative of wave functions, waveforms in the atmosphere, just effectively go back to minus of the original. So this is just like a plus sign of the advection of temperature over here. So we just have plus thermal advection. Well, on the left-hand side, we have a three-dimensional Laplace operator over here, which is going to effectively be something like a minus sign acting on omega. Well, that's just like a minus omega is like a W. Remember, as we go up with height, we're dealing with decreasing pressure, so dp dt over time, if we're talking about a value that is negative, we have experiencing upward motion, and that's going to be the same as a positive W. So conceptually, this can be linked to W over here. Minus omega is like W, scaled now by sigma, or static stability. So the quasi-geostrophic omega equation is saying that the static stability scaling the vertical motion, now we're talking about W, so like dz dt instead of dp dt, is being driven by or is a response to forcing terms of differential vorticity advection and thermal advection.